So what does the random program look like that killed Clang? So here we have a bunch of preamble stuff at the top. And let's get down to the random code. Okay, here's the random code itself. And so what you can see is just basically it's just a bunch of random junk. And so what are we doing here? We're making function calls. We have a little integer constant. We have some relational operators. And so this is a large-ish program. Let's see how big it is. This program is, it's not that big. It's 1,600 lines or 37 kilobytes of code. But right now, we don't know what about that program it was that caused Clang to crash. All we know is that crashed it. So let's just look and make sure that that works. Okay, good. So here you can see that Clang did indeed die on that input. And so we can see that here we see the assertion failure, unknown live in to the entry block. And then the rest of this is just a bunch of sort of other information that Clang gives when it crashes. For example, it's a stack trace of functions that were actually executing when the compiler crashed. It's giving us a detailed version of the arguments and some other stuff. So this is all stuff that we would include in the bug report when I report this bug to the LLVM developers, which I'll do tonight after I finish recording lectures. So let's see now if we found anything about GCC that's interesting. And so here we saw that LLVM always includes this assertion string when it crashes, and GCC includes a different message all the time. It's internal compiler error. Okay, and so what we can see here is that several times GCC responded with a message saying that it was killed. And these do not represent compiler bugs that we're interested in. These are just performance pathologies where the compiler ran for quite a while on some random input. And those tend to be hard to report as bugs, so we're not going to worry about that. What we can see is that there was one internal compiler error where verify SSA failed. I believe that's a known bug, so we're not going to worry about it. There's a segmentation fault where GCC crashed, and most often that's due to dereferencing a null pointer. We're not going to worry about that either. There's an error in git loop body. That happens to be a known bug. That bug's been reported. And then we have an error here, which looks to me to be new. We have internal compiler error in git initial def for induction at treevect. And so treevect means that error was in the loop vectorizer, which is a module of GCC that's been getting quite a bit of development and quite a bit of attention in recent years. This is a place where we would sort of expect to find bugs. And so I'm not going to go generate the program that caused this crash, since we already saw that example for Clang. Basically, what we've seen here is how a random testing loop works. And so if we actually look at the activity on this machine, we can see that lots of programs are running here involving evaluate program as one of the driver scripts for the random tester. CSmith, of course, is a random test case generator. CC1 and Clang are compiler processes. So this compiler is sitting here using all 8 cores on a rather fast modern machine in order to break compilers.